Don't disappoint him. If you who are chosen to carry his light, carry his power and presence, if you are not mad after him to possess him, so our life is, as we read in the book of Philippians, chapter 3, verse 7 and 8, he says, I run after the one who is running after me. Can you look at somebody next to you or who are next to you? Can you ask them, are you running after? Again, are you running after the one who is running after you? Day and night, he runs after you. He waits for you. We read in 1 Chronicles chapter 16, verse 9. Like the bird that hovers around the earth, the eyes of the Lord are on those who look for him, who hunger for him. Do you hunger for him? He's waiting. He's looking after you. Is this man coming to me to get something to survive? Is this lady coming to me to get some help? Very good. That all he will do. Is that life is all about? Is that spirituality all about? I don't think so. The eyes of the Lord is looking for those who hunger for him. Hunger for him. That's why in Philippians chapter 3, what St. Paul says,
but once I found Christ, all those things that I might have considered as profit, I think as loss.
Once I have found him,
as profit,
it is there. It is in the presence of the light. I understand the cruelty of darkness. How I fallen in darkness. How I was struggling in darkness. You realize only when you are in the light. While I have caught hold of him, I strive after him, I recognize everything as rubbish. God is calling each one of us. We read in the book of Daniel chapter 4. Even after the revelation was given to the king, one day the king went to the palace and he said, oh Nebuchadnezzar, oh all these things you have built. Then the voice from heaven came, cut down this tree. The tree was cut. Yet 1 second is enough for God to take away your thinking power. Within a minute, the thinking power of the king was taken away. The so-called great king Nebuchadnezzar became like an animal. He ran to the forest. Yes, his nails started to grow. His skin started to grow like an animal. One day, God in his mercy gave him back to his senses. He returned. He cried. He cried, Lord, you made me a king. You gave me your glory. But I was not after you. I allowed the world to rule me. I allowed the world and the flesh to ruin me. Still, I was not striving for you. Still, my soul was not hungering for you. I know the moment I come to you, the flesh will pull me down. But only the fellow who runs cannot be caught. I have to be run after you. I have to hunger for you more than the hunger of the food and the flesh. If I don't possess you, if I don't make the effort of my life, the goal of my life to bring glory and honor to you, I am going to be landed up somewhere else or someone else's lap. Open my eyes, Lord. to see your glory, Lord. Open my eyes, Lord, to your truth, Lord, the truth that sets me free. You said, Lord, if the Son of Man delivers you, you are delivered indeed. You said, Lord, in 1 John 5:12, he who has the Son will have the life of the Son. He who doesn't have the Son of God will be left out with the world alone. Lord, you said in 1 John 5:18, he who is born of God keeps the Lord with him, with her. Is my life journey to keep my God with me, to take my God along with me, to have his glory as the crown of my life for me. 1 John 5:18, he who is born of God keeps his God with him, and the enemy cannot touch him. The enemy sees whether God is in you. Jesus is walking with you. If Jesus is walking with you, he will not dare to come near you. Because if he comes near, he will be burnt off. If the enemy is at work in you, means you have not caught hold of him. You have not striving after him. Not striving enough of him. Lifting up your hands. Hunger for him. To be with you, my Lord, is the desire of my heart. To do your will, O God, is the delight of my soul. To be with you, my Lord, is the desire of my heart. To do your will, O God, is the delight of my soul. Lord Jesus, I long for you, like the deer pants for the stream. When shall I behold your face? You alone are my God. To be with you, my Lord, is the desire of my heart. To do your will, O God, is the delight of my soul. Lord, you loved me. So in order to forgive my sins, you know that I cannot conquer my sin. Knowingly, unknowingly, I am fallen in the trap of evil. And there is only one power that can cleanse me and bring me back from Satan to you. That is your blood. In the book of Acts of the Apostle, chapter 20, what is human life? How the Holy Spirit guides man, and what do I do with my life? St. Paul tells us in a nutshell, in just 3 sentences. Shall we listen to him? Close your eyes, lift up your hands, and with great hunger, receive this treasure. Acts of the Apostle, chapter 20, verse 22 to 24.
But now I am going to Jerusalem.
Now I am going to Jerusalem.
Chained by the Spirit.
But I am always chained by the Holy Spirit. Whatever may be happen, I am under the clutches of the Spirit.
Without knowing what will happen to me there.
When I am under the Spirit, I need not bother what is going to happen to me.
Yet in every city.
In every city wherever I go.
The Holy Spirit warns me that.
The Holy Spirit is warning me.
Imprisonment and troubles await me.
Imprisonment and troubles are waiting for me. But they are not affecting me. Because I know. The Holy Spirit is surrounding me. And He is carrying me. Hunger for this life. When that life comes. He says in verse 24, you could tell like Paul.
Indeed, I put no value for my life. If only I can finish my race.
All my desire is, if only I can finish my race.
And complete the service.
And complete the purpose for which my God created me. The service. To which
I have been assigned by the Lord Jesus.
My God trusted me and He has assigned me for a mission.
To announce the good news of God's grace.
To announce the good news of God's grace. Yes, God has called me.